Hi, in this section, we will be taking laws of indices. The index of a number is the number of times the number is multiplied by itself. It is also the power to which the number is raised. So when you multiply a number by itself, 2 multiplied by 2, it shows the power to which it is raised. So the number is the base of the quantity. The power, which is the index, is also known as the exponent. So for example, given any quantity, a raised to power x, a is the base and x is the index. Then in 2 raised to power 3, that means 2 is multiplied by itself 3 times. The base is 2 and the exponent is 3. Checking out the laws. Law 1 states that if bases of a multiplied expression are equal, had the exponent. So we have a raised to power m multiplied by a raised to power n. We can see that a, the base, is the same. So a raised to power m plus n. In example 1, we have 2 raised to power 2 multiplied by 2 raised to power 3, which is equals to 2 raised to power 2 plus 3, which is equals to 2 raised to power 5. Law 2 states that if exponents are equal in an expression, solve the base. So we have a raised to power m multiplied by b raised to power m, which is equals to a multiplied by b raised to power m, which is equals to ab raised to power m. Example 2, we have 2 raised to power 2 multiplied by 3 raised to power 2, which is equals to 2 multiplied by 3 raised to power 2. Then that is equals to 6 raised to power 2, which is equals to 36. Laws 3 and 4 is like laws 1 and 2. Law 3 states that if bases of a division expression are equal, subtract the exponents. Law 1 states that if the bases of a multiplied expression are equal, you had. So in division, you subtract. So we have a raised to power m divided by a raised to power n, which is equals to a raised to power m minus n. Then in example 3, we have 2 raised to power 4 divided by 2 raised to power 2, which is equals to 2 raised to power 4 minus 2, which is equals to 2 raised to power 2. Law 4 states that if exponents are equal in an expression, solve the base. So we have a raised to power m divided by b raised to power m. So we can see that the exponents or the powers are equal. So what we just have is a all over b raised to power m. So in example 4, we can see 2 raised to power 2 divided by 3 raised to power 2 is equals to 2 all over 3 or 2 divided by 3 exponential 2. In law 5, it states that if a base number is raised to a power in a bracket and raised to another power, multiply the power. So we have a raised to power n in bracket raised to power m, which is equals to a raised to power m multiplied by n, or we can have a raised to power m in bracket raised to power n. So for example 5, we have 2 raised to power 4 in bracket raised to power 2. To simplify that, we have 2 raised to power 4 multiplied by 2, which is equals to 2 raised to power 8. So also we can have 2 raised to power 4 raised to power 2. We can have it as 2 raised to power 2 raised to power 4. Then when we want to simplify 2 raised to power 2, we have 4 raised to power 4. In law 6, we have 2 variations of law 6, and we will look at the 2. A raised to power m root n. Anytime you have root, the figure outside it, then you can have it as a raised to power 1 over n. The root becomes 1 over the number outside. Do you understand that? Then which is equals to a raised to power 1 over n in brackets raised to power m, or a raised to power m in brackets raised to power 1 over n, which is equals to a raised to power m over n. So in example 6, 64 root 3, which is the cube root of 64, it is equals to 4 raised to power 3 root 3, which is equals to 4 raised to power 3 in brackets over 1 over 3. When you simplify that exponential, you have 4 raised to power 3 multiplied by 1 over 3, which is equals to 4 raised to power 1, which is equals to 1. So the other variation follows that every number is associated with the powers of 1. So any number, even without powers on it, is the number raised to power 1. So a is equals to a raised to power 1, 2 is equals to 2 raised to power 1, then 10 is equals to 10 raised to power 1. So we can say 64 root 3 is equals to 64 raised to power 1 root 3, which is equals to 64 root 1 over 3. Don't forget, in the first section, we have anything root, it becomes 1 over. Then equals, when we simplify 64, we have 4 root 3, which is 4 multiplied by 4. Multiplied by 4 is equals to 64 in brackets 1 over 3. When you simplify 3 multiplied by 1 over 3, the exponent, your answer is equals to 4. Law 7 states that the square root of any number is number raised to power half. It's just from root law 6 that we say that the root becomes 1 over. Then when you have the square root sign without any number, it means 2 is outside. So we have a raised to power 1 over 2. So that is have a raised to power half. If you have root 4 or square root 4, is equals to 4 over 4 raised to power 1 over 2, which is equals to 2 raised to power 2 in brackets raised to power half. When we simplify that, we have 2 raised to power 2 multiplied by half, which is equals to 2 raised to power 1, which is equals to 2. Law 8 states that any non-zero base number raised to power 0 equals 1. So a raised to power 0 is equals to 1. Where a is not equals to 0, then 0 raised to power 0 is not equals to 1. So when we want to see how we get that, from law 3, a raised to power n divided by a raised to power n is equals to, you know, you remember you subtract when the base are equal. You have a raised to power n minus n, which is equals to a raised to power 0. That is equation 1. Or we can say a raised to power n over a raised to power n. When you simplify that, you divide, you have 1, which is equation 2. Which we can now see our equation 1 is equals to equation 2. Therefore, a raised to power 0 is equals to 1. So in example 8, 2 raised to power 0, 5 raised to power 0, 100 raised to power 0, 56 raised to power 0, anything raised to power 0 is equals to 1. In law 9, it states that 1 raised to power any number, which the any number is represented as n, which may be a positive integer, it may be a fraction or a decimal, is equals to 1. So n raised to power, 1 raised to power n, I mean, is equals to 1. So in example how 9, we have 1 raised to power 100, 1 raised to power 0.001, 1 raised to power 99, everything is equals to 1. Then law 10, the final law we'll be looking at, states that a raised to power minus n is equals to 1 over a raised to power n. Then we should note that minus n is equals to 0 minus n. Anywhere they just put minus, just know that if there is no number preceding it, it is 0 minus the number. So we can write that a raised to power minus n is equals to a raised to power 0 minus n. So from law 3, a raised to power 0 minus n is equals to a raised to power 0, you remember from law 3, over a raised to power n. Then also from law 8, a raised to power 0 is equals to 1. You can check back the laws to understand better how the equations are gotten. So a raised to power 0 over a raised to power n is equal to, since a raised to power 0, anything raised to power 0 is 1, then we have 1 raised to power 1 over a raised to power n. So in example 10, 2 raised to power minus 2 is equal to 1 over 2 raised to power 2, and also 7 raised to power minus 3 is equals to 1 over 7 raised to power 3. So we will look at an illustrative example to see better how the laws of indices apply. In any equation you have to evaluate, you may use more than one law. Just be careful on how you apply the laws so that you would arrive at a correct answer. So we are asked to evaluate 5 raised to power x multiplied by 25 raised to power x minus 1 over 125x plus 1. So when we want to solve for that, we bring out the equations to bring them down to their lowest prime numbers so that it will be easy for us to evaluate and simplify the equation. So we have 25 raised to power x minus 1, which is equals to 5 raised to power 2. You know, it is 5 multiplied by 2, which is 25. So we have 5 raised to power 2 in bracket x minus 1. When we simplify that, we have 5 raised to power 2x minus 2. 125x plus 1 is equals to 5 raised to power 3 in bracket x plus 1. When we simplify that, we have 5 raised to power 3x plus 3. Then we want to bring what we've simplified into the equation. Therefore, we have 5 raised to power x multiplied by 25 raised to power x minus 1 over 125x 125 raised to power x plus 1. It is equals to 5x multiplied by, when we want to insert what we got for 25 raised to power x minus 1, we have 5 raised to power 2x minus 2 all over 5 raised to power 3x plus 3, which is for the equation under. Then when we simplify that, from law 1, don't forget, when you have multiplication, you add. So we now add the equation on top together because there is a multiplication sign there. We have 5x plus 5 raised to power x plus 2x minus 2 over 5x 5 raised to power 3x plus 3. Then from law 3, don't forget that when you have division, what do? You subtract. So we have 5 raised to power 3 minus x minus, we are putting it in brackets because I want you to see something. We cannot just bring the equation there because the minus sign will have effect on everything that is inside the brackets. We will see when we simplify that. So we have 5 raised to power 3x minus 2 in brackets minus 3x plus 3 in brackets, which is equals to 5 raised to power 3x minus 2. Then when we want to simplify the brackets, minus times plus 3x becomes minus 3x, minus times plus 3 becomes minus 3. So we have 5 raised to power 3x minus 2 minus 3x minus 3. Then when we want to simplify further, we see that in the exponential equation, plus 3 minus 3 will cancel itself. Then minus 2 minus 3 becomes minus 5. So we have 5 raised to power minus 5, which is equals to 1 over 5 raised to power 5. In summary, we looked at 10 laws of indices, which can be applied to solve any expression when needed. What you just have to understand is, which law should I apply at each step? Then the powers and bases with their mathematical sign should be well noted in any equation to avoid mistake. So you must note when you have the subtraction sign in the raised to power. You must note when you have the division or the multiplication sign so that you arrive at your correct answers. Behind this are practice questions. You can check your understanding of the law of indices we've talked about in this session, and also you can lay your hands on any past question or any textbook and see. You can also solve for yourself other practice questions.